Hi, I'm Sanjay Nagchowdhury, Development Lead for the IBM App Connect Enterprise product. In my previous two videos, I described how to view deployed message flows and separately how to retrieve and import resources that are deployed to an integration server. In this video, I will show further examples of using the capability to retrieve and import resources. The capability was added in IBM App Connect Enterprise version 12.0.8. So I've connected to an integration server here. It has various applications, libraries, policy projects deployed to it. At the integration server level, I can select a new menu option, which is called Retrieve and Import Resources. And when I open that wizard, I can see a list of applications at the top and a list of policy projects at the bottom. So I can select an application. I'm going to select the same one that I selected in my previous video, so demo app underscore retrieve, and I'll select a policy project as well. When I click next, I can see the resources are contained in the application, and after I click finish, the application and the policy project are installed in my workspace. So I can see the message flow, the map, and eSQL. I can also see the policy project as well. So I can open up the message flow. And the message flow is shown as usual in the message flow editor, and I can edit it in the normal way. I can also open the map, and I can access eSQL from a compute node. I can also open the policy in the policy editor, and I can see the properties and values in the policy. So all of these resources were retrieved from the application that was deployed to an integration server. So I'm going to go through some more examples now. So if I select the same menu option to retrieve and import resources, this time I'm going to select an application which uses a static library. So when I click next, I can see the message flow and it's using two static libraries. If I click finish, I'm informed that the application is using a static library, and after importing, the reference to the static library will need to be manually added. So I can see that there are some red crosses, there are six errors here. The message flow that is in the application is using a subflow, which is in a static library. So I need to fix the library references by select manage library references and select the static library that it needs. And click OK, then the red crosses disappear. Now this static library in turn is using a subflow that is in another static library. So we can see the red crosses here as well. So again, I need to select the static library, select manage library references, and select the relevant static library, and click OK, and now those red crosses all disappear. So I can repeat the same process. This time I'm going to select the same application again. And I want to do this because I want to show that I can select this checkbox here to say I don't want to import these static libraries because they are already in my workspace. So it's just going to create the application and the message flow. Now when I click finish, it will warn me that the application already exists in the workspace, so it's actually going to be deleted and created again. So I'm going to click Delete Projects, and now it tells me that I'll need to add the library reference to the application, so I'll click OK to that. And now the application has been re-imported. I'll need to select Manage Library References again, and select the static library, and click OK. And now the red crosses disappear. Let's try another example. So I'm going to select Retrieve and Import Resources again. This time I'm going to select this application here called My App. When I click Next, I can see that it has two message flows, it's using a static library, and it also has references to these six shared libraries. Now after we import, you'll see that there are actually two subflows that are needed that are used in library A and outer shared library, but they in turn use subflows in these other shared libraries, so they are using nested shared libraries. The wizard has calculated all the nested shared libraries that are needed and lists them in this view. So I don't need to re-import the static library, so I'm going to deselect that, but I'm going to click finish here, and that's going to import the application, the message flows, and the shared libraries. So I'll click finish, and it's informing me that the application is using a static library, so I'll need to add reference. So there's my app. Here are the shared libraries. I will just add the reference to the static library. Click OK. So that fixes the red errors. Now let's have a look at the message flow. So the message flow is using two subflows, one in library A and one in outer shared library. So have a look, let's have a look at the reference shared library. So library A is using a subflow that is in library B, and library B is using a subflow that is in library C. So all of these nested shared libraries have been imported. Again, similarly, outer shared library has a subflow which is using a subflow in middle shared library, and that is using a subflow that is in inner shared library. So all of those shared libraries have been imported. Let's show another example. I'm going to select retrieve and import resources, and this time I'm going to select this application here, transformation_java. And when I click next here, I see an error. It's showing me a warning. It's telling me that the jar file is not supported for conversion back to its source format. So if you are using a Java compute node where a jar file has been created, we cannot import that into your workspace. We're informed of this by the wizard. And you are still able to import the application. If you read the top message, it says the selected application contains one or more resources which cannot be retrieved. The application can only be imported if the option to continue is selected below. So at the moment, the finish button is grayed out, but if I select this checkbox here to continue to import the application, then the finish button is enabled. So this will import the message flow and this input.xml resource. So if I click finish, the application is created. The message flow is also in the workspace, but there is a red cross because we don't have the Java source code. So the Java source code will need to be imported by other means. Let's do another example. Let's select retrieve and import resources. This time I'm going to select Hello App. Now Hello App has a message flow which is using CMF. So it's using the compiled message flow format. We cannot currently import this back into the workspace. So again, you see the same error. The message flow is grayed out. If we click continue to import, it would create the application with only these two XML resources. So if I click finish, Hello App is created, but the message flow is not there and it just has the XML files that were in the application. Similarly, if I select retrieve and import resources and select an application which is using MRM message sets, if I click next, I see errors about the .dictionary not being supported and the XSDZIP not being able to be imported. So .dictionary and .XSDZIP cannot be imported. If I click continue to import and select finish, it will import the message flow, the eSQL, and the static library will be empty. So if I click finish there, I get a warning that the reference needs to be added to the static library, but the message flow is imported, but there is no message set imported into the workspace. Two more examples. So I'm going to do a retrieve and import resources, and this time select a REST API. So I'm going to select the Pet Store REST API and click next. And this time I can see the resources for the Pet Store API. If I click finish, I can see the Pet Store API has been imported. I can see the subflows which implement the operation. I can double click on the REST API description, and I can see the REST API definition. And finally, I can select the retrieve and import resources, and this time I'm going to select an integration service. I'm going to select temperature converter. Click next. I can see the resources that are used by the integration service. I click finish. The integration service is imported into the workspace, and I can see the resources for it. I can see the subflows which implement the operations, and I can double click on the integration service description, and I can see the definition of the integration service. So in this video, I've shown how to use the new capability to retrieve and import resources that are deployed to an integration server. The capability was added in IBM App Connect Enterprise version 12.0.8.